Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. Topic 10, Alternative Text.
If you have a picture, graphic, or chart on your website or other digital material, you'll want to make sure to describe it properly. Consider 8-year-old Kai's experience reading with a screen reader as he came upon an image.
It wasn't able to read what was on the screen just because there was no descriptive words, and so it would just say nothing.
We don't want Kai or other students to have that same experience, so let's talk about what he called descriptive words.
Descriptive words, or alternative text, also known as alt text, are the words used to describe an image to people who cannot see it, but who need access to the information it conveys. Alt text is important because people who are blind, visually impaired, or who otherwise need content read to them are not able to understand the context of an image unless it is described to them. Alt text doesn't normally appear on a screen unless the designer has made it available to all users on mouse hover.
What's important to remember here is context. Think about why an image is on the web page and what information the reader is supposed to get from it.
Let's look at this picture from the Library of Congress of a pair of boots as an example. If it's a historical artifact posted on a town's history page, then my alternative text might be, "Boots from the mid-1850s as town was being founded." But if the boots are being used on a photographer's webpage to showcase her work, the alternative text might say, "Black and white photograph of low-rise leather boots facing away from each other on a concrete rooftop with strong use of texture throughout." However, if the picture is being used to help set the ambiance for a web page, and users aren't expected to get any content from the photo, then you can skip the alt text and simply mark the photo decorative. So, when it comes to alternative text, make sure the description fits the context of the main content on your page and the purpose of the image. Quick tip, think about what you want your readers to learn from the image, not just describing the image.
As you can see, there's a lot of leeway in terms of how to write your alternative text. But the one thing we don't recommend is using something like shoes-22.jpg or slideshow image 1. Try to avoid using image titles as the alternative text. It's convenient, but it's not helpful to your users using screen readers or other assistive technology. Let's look at another example. This is a graphic image containing text. It's a promotional poster for a Halloween roller skating carnival. Your school may use an image like this to promote events at your educational community. You'll notice that all of the event details are on the image, so you have two options. Option 1, include all of the important descriptive information about the event in your alternative text. So, our alternative text might read, "Halloween Roller Skating Carnival on the Mall, Central Park, October 31st, 8:30 p.m. Bring your own skates. Prizes will be awarded for costumes. Brought to you by the Department of Parks, City of New York." Or option 2, mark the image as decorative and include all the important descriptive information nearby. Important. What you don't want to do is say something like, "Announcement for upcoming Halloween roller skating carnival," without giving people who use assistive technology the same information that is available to everyone else. Notably, the location, dates and times, and that prizes will be awarded for costumes. Don't just describe the purpose of the image, give the information.
Visuals help tell what you're talking about on your webpage, so make sure that those who can't easily view the visual can still understand the relevant information by way of alternative text or by repeating the same information on your webpage in an accessible way. So remember, context matters. Include the relevant information. And consider what Lisa Maria, who is blind and a mom of 3 kids, has to say.
There's ways to make visual information non-visual, and it's just a matter of considering that all types of people are going to access this.
This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov /OCR or email us at OCR@ED.gov.